Hello everyone, peace of Christ to all. In this video we will show you something kind of funny about Islam and Muslims, and show you the confusion of those Muslims. If we ask Muslims what Islam is about, who is the Muslim? The Muslim will start saying to you, Adam is a Muslim, Moses is a Muslim, Isa is a Muslim, Muhammad is a Muslim, and not only that, you yourself, you are a Muslim. Yeah, you are born as a Muslim, but later you leave Islam. Which means, if you are a son of a Christian family, they will make you Christian. If you are a son of a Jew family, they will make you a Jew. So when you are a baby, you are a Muslim. But this doesn't stop there. The Muslims, as we see in chapter 22, verse number 18, it says, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَسْجُدُ لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ وَالنُّجُومُ وَالْجِبَالُ وَالشَّجَرُ وَالدَّوَابُ وَكَثِيرٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ. Seats, though not that to Allah, bow down, worship all things that are in heavens and on earth, the sun, the moon, the stars, the hills, and the trees, the animals, the great numbers among mankind. Now, if we look in here, we will see something very funny. The stars worship Allah. The moon worship Allah. The sun worship Allah. Now somebody will say to me, oh, this is a metaphor meaning. No, this is not a true. Worship as a worship. Because, bow down. And here, we're not talking about a dream. Like, somebody will say, a prophet, he saw a dream about the stars, they are bowing down to God. This is a dream, this is a vision, but doesn't mean that they have a different meaning, have a metaphor meaning. And here it's talking about physical bowing down, physical worshipping. Bowing down in Islam is a physical movement you do to worship. It's not a metaphor. It's something real. It's something physical. So I'm not going to ask the Muslims how the stars will bow down, how the moon will bow down, how the sun will bow down, but I want to concentrate in something else. Before we go there, how the animals worship their God. If there is any Muslim can explain to us how animals they worship Allah, we will be so glad to see. How a mosquito, she worship Allah. And actually, I will play a video for you in our chat room as a debate. You will see me and the Muslim, we are debating about this issue. And you will hear him saying, you know what? It's better you hear it yourself, not to hear it from me. Let us go to the video and see how all animals and even the sun, even the star, they are Muslims, and even the sun, he might go to hell if he don't obey God. He, and I will put two lines under the word he. Listen to the video, watch it, and enjoy. He just said, pigs are Muslims, as long he is obeying Allah. How a pig he obey Allah, and how he disobey Allah. When the pig, we will be out of Islam, and when the pig will be a good Muslim, you're mine.
Everything in the universe is
as long as the pig is not doing anything unnatural, that is natural for him, is he's obeying the laws, the natural laws of God. The difference between human beings and other entities, including inanimate beings, is
you did not answer yet. How a pig he will not be a Muslim? How a pig will leave Islam? Let us say you are saying the one, the good pig is the one who obeyed the law of Allah. Great. Now the bad pig who is out of Islam, what he did? Give us an example to understand. Your mind.
Why do I have to exactly use your words, and you have to put your words in my mouth, brother? Let me have a minute to answer what I'm saying, so people can understand and you can understand. If you just dot me, then and if I don't say what you think I should say, you red dot me. That's not fair in my view. In my view, anything that is natural is obeying the natural laws is a Muslim, including the pig, including the tiger. If the tiger starts to eat grass, he is not being a Muslim, because it's unnatural for him. If a pig starts to fly, then he is not a Muslim. You understand? And the difference between natural
Okay, from your logic, this is mean the Muslims who fly in airplane, they are no human no more. Actually, they are no Muslims no more. So by flying by an airplane, you are out of Islam. You're my.
No, we can make a joke about anything, but in the case of human beings, we have free choice. That is what makes it a little bit more precarious for us, because animals do not have choice. They have no choice. They have to obey the laws of the Almighty. In our case, we have been given a little bit of choice. Still, I cannot, just jump and fly off like a bird. I have to stay walking unless I can devise an airplane, and there is nothing wrong in.
Forgive me, IME. Just wait. I'm just trying to understand you, really. You said if a tiger eat a grass, he is out of Islam. Okay, is it a sin to eat a grass? What if you like to eat a grass? What's wrong? Actually, I saw some wild animals, wild, they eat meat. They eat a grass. There's a reason for that. So is that a sin to eat a grass? What's wrong with that? Why Allah will consider this animal out of Islam if he eat a grass? Tiger, he start eating grass. Why Allah is getting upset, your mind?
First, we need to understand what we understand as sin. From Islamic perspective, from what the Prophet has taught us, a sin happens only and only when God tells you not to do something and you're doing it, or he tells you to do something and you're not doing it. And until that happens, you cannot have a sin. In other words, if God did not say, do not murder, it would not be a sin to murder. But because he has said, don't murder, that's why it is murder. If not, you don't go and put a tiger in jail because he's killing some animal, and even killing another tiger. So in our understanding, sin happens when you deliberately disobey God Almighty. And that's when you're not being a Muslim, you're not following the laws.
You see, you are just contradicting yourself. You just said that if God did not say, don't do that, it's okay to do it. Now, show me where Allah, he said to the tiger, don't eat the grass. Show me where Allah, he said to the pig, don't fly, as you said. Show me. I ask you, how a tiger will leave Islam? He said, if he not disobey the law of Allah by eating grass. Show me the law of Allah where it says, tiger, he have to eat only meat. Show me that law. You're mine.
But the natural law is embedded in their genes, brother. They always eat meat. If the tiger eats grass, he may have, some medicinal needs, and he might do that. What I'm saying is, naturally, what you do is Islam, and you're obedient to God. That's what Islam means, is obedience to God. So that's why when we say Moses is a Muslim, we are not saying that Moses is following the Prophet or reading the Quran or going to Hajj. We are saying Moses is obedient to God. That's all we mean. Because we don't understand each other,
Okay, from last time I understand you, that even rocks are Muslims. Rocks are Muslims, but rocks don't do anything. How a rock can be obedient or disobedient to God? A rock, even the rock for you, are Muslims. Explain to the room how a rock can be obedience or disobedience to God. You're mine.
Yeah, this is where the choice, free choice, comes in. Those that do not have free choice are Muslim without choice. Son is a Muslim in the sense that he is obedient to God and he is doing what God has ordained him to do, and he's doing it. So he's a Muslim. The man alone among...
Son, he is a Muslim. He is? Son, he is? What do you mean he is? The son is a man, or what do you mean he is? You're my...
Thinking about the good things to come, and I believe it could be something good has begun. Oh, I've been smiling,
Muhammad,
dreaming about the world at one, and I believe it could be someday it's going to come.
Prophet Muhammad. Muhammad.
The Prophet
Muhammad.